Today I'm going to talk about refurbishing of consumer returns and their impact on a company's profits. Recently, there has been an exponential increase in per capita consumption, largely due to a combination of shortening product life cycle and increasing purchasing power. However, the resources required to produce such consumer products are in limited supply and largely non-renewable. For instance, of 83 stable elements found on periodic table, at least 70 are used in smartphones. In fact, of 17 rare earth metals, 16 are included in smartphones. In addition, toxic chemicals, especially from electronic waste, have severe negative consequences on environment. These negative consequences have led to growing environmental awareness among consumers and increasing regulations. Therefore, firms are required to adopt environmentally responsible practices such as refurbishing, in which firms can extend life of existing products and thereby reduce consumption of raw materials. However, balancing profitability and sustainability for firms is not an easy decision. In fact, sometimes firms believe that if they follow sustainable practices, it might hurt their profits. This is because for companies, whether to sell refurbished products or not is not a straightforward decision, since on one hand, refurbished products can expand the market sales. On the other hand, they might also cannibalize a company's new product sales. My research aims to understand implications of refurbishing on a company which offers both new and refurbished products together. In one of my research papers, I study refurbishing of consumer returns arising from product defects. These days, companies face a lot of pressure to launch newer and more innovative products faster, which sometimes leads to quality problems and defective products, eventually leading to more consumer returns. For instance, Samsung's attempt to launch new Galaxy Note 7 resulted in quality problems to such an extent that they had to recall that product altogether. In this paper, I basically address two questions. One is, when should a firm offer refurbished products and how should the firm price those products? Second, what is the implication of defective returns on a firm's profit? What I find is that more returns are not necessarily a bad thing for a company when company refurbishes these defective returns. In fact, under certain conditions, the firm can be better off with more defective returns. And the reason lies in strategic behavior of consumers. Typically, companies have incentive to lower prices over time in order to capture lower end of the markets. Consumers, being strategic, they anticipate the firm's this behavior and they reduce their willingness to pay for those products. However, under refurbishing, when there are more defective returns, company refurbishes the defective products rather than giving discounts on new products. And consumers anticipate this and they buy the new product at high prices, and this benefits the firm. In a nutshell, a company that refurbishes these defective products is in a better position to launch newer and more innovative products and at faster pace. Thanks.